knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
So far in this botany series, we have gained a reasonable understanding of the world of plants. To achieve this, we examined plant cells, tissues, organs, organ systems, mechanisms of growth, evolution, plant classification, and much more. In doing so, we have built upon our pre-existing knowledge of biomolecules and cellular processes in a way that is specific to the plant kingdom. However, there's a lot more to discuss than the basic information we have covered thus far, so now we are going to dive into some more detailed information that will be of use to those who intend to go a little deeper with their study of plants. The first topic we will cover in this endeavor over the next handful of tutorials is dendrochronology. Dendrochronology is a term derived from the Greek words for tree, or dendron, time, or chronos, and the suffix logia, which translates in English to mean the science of, or study of. So, as the study of trees over time, dendrochronology is truly the science of tree rings, which are visible rings of outward growth that can be examined by looking at a cross-section of a tree, with each ring representing 1 year of growth, proceeding forwards in time from the center outwards. It is a diverse field that has applications in archaeology, chemistry, climate science, geology, history, forestry, and natural resource management. Essentially, it is a form of environmental monitoring that uses trees as long-term bioindicators, because trees can record any factor, whether caused by nature or by humans, that impacts the process of ring formation. Dendrochronologists can study very old trees to learn about past temperatures, rainfall, insect outbreaks, fires, and other environmental disasters. They can also study large numbers of relatively young trees to reveal information about localized or global climatic shifts. In addition, wood from long-dead trees, whether in houses, barns, roads, or ships, can be used to expand existing chronologies further back in time and date archaeological finds. Tree rings, along with ice cores, corals, and subfossil pollen in lake sediment, provide a type of climatological proxy data. This means that they can be used instead of direct meteorological measurements to reveal past climate information, and we'll cover exactly how this is done a bit later. Compared to these other forms of proxy data, tree rings provide a relatively short record in that most chronologies date from 400 to 1,000 years, with only a handful reaching over 10,000 years. However, they are considered to be a very reliable form of proxy data, especially for tracking recent climatic shifts, since trees record this data within their very bodies. Forests are living libraries that catalog the natural world. Trees are like books or journals. They store information about their past. Using dendrochronology, we can reveal some of the mysteries trees hide and learn about their past in order to better predict their future. Did a single tree have an insect infestation, or did an entire forest suffer? Are some tree species more sensitive to climatic shifts than others? What did the forest that lived in an area long ago really look like, and what might the forests of the future look like? The goal of the next few tutorials in this series will be to provide you with a solid background in dendrochronology rather than just a brief overview. In order to do this, we will need to first go over the foundational principles and concepts of dendrochronology. Then we can get into more detail on the growth and structure of wood using some of the vocabulary from earlier in the botany series. Then we can examine the field, lab, and computational procedures necessary to successfully analyze a tree core and build a chronology. Finally, we will go over some of the subfields of dendrochronology and wrap up the miniseries. Once we are finished, you may start looking at trees just a bit differently, hopefully with an enhanced awareness of their complexity and utility. So, without further delay, let's learn about dendrochronology.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.